Hello students, we shall be meeting through this video lectures till college opens again. I hope all of you are good in health, and at the same time you should study on your own. Of course, this is the way we have found out to help you in studying. Let us hope that these video lectures would help you learning this subject as well as the other subjects. So I welcome all of you to the first lecture of the subject Foundation of Communication and Computer Network, Unit 5. In this, we shall be studying the multiplexing and multiple accesses. The multiplexing we have different types of multiplexing: frequency division multiplexing, wavelength division multiplexing, and two different types of time division multiplexing. This is what we are going to see in the beginning in this particular unit, and particularly in this lecture we shall focus on frequency division multiplexing. The other types of multiplexing we shall see in the next lecture. So first of all, what is multiplexing? Multiplexing is a set of techniques that allows simultaneous transmission of multiple signals across a single data link. In the digital electronics, you might have studied multiplexing. Multiplexers you might have studied. So multiplexer, what it does is that it combines the multiple inputs into a single input. So similar kind of thing you can expect in this particular multiplexing. Here you have different signal to be transmitted or to be sent from the transmitter to the receiver. Okay, we know that in the communication system there is a sender and there is a receiver, and the signals are to be sent, information is to be sent from the sender to the receiver. But when it is required to send multiple information from sender to the receiver, then we use multiplexing. This is how we can show the multiplexing in the graphical form. There are n number of input lines. There is a multiplexer, as you might have studied in the digital electronics. This multiplexer combines all these inputs into a single channel. There is a single channel, and this single channel carries all the inputs together, and at the receiver this particular inputs or the signals which were sent at the transmitter are demultiplexed and they are separated. So if we are sending n signals at the transmitter, then the demultiplexer decomposes these n signals. So we get the different signals at the receiver. So this is what is the multiplexing. So as it was discussed in the beginning, there are three different categories of multiplexing. First one is the frequency division multiplexing, wavelength division multiplexing, and time division multiplexing. So we shall see these three different types of multiplexing one after another. So let us first see the frequency division multiplexing in this particular lecture. The frequency division multiplexing is an analog multiplexing technique that combines the analog signal. In the second unit, we have already discussed the modulation. So we know that in the modulation, there is a modulating signal and there is a carrier signal. The modulating signal changes some of the characteristics of the modulating signal, and what we get is the frequency modulated signal or amplitude modulated signal or the phase modulated signal. Now when this modulating is done, if we select carriers of different frequencies for the different modulating signals, and if these carriers are well separated from each other, considering the bandwidth required for each signal, then it is possible to achieve this particular frequency division multiplexing. That is, in the frequency division multiplexing, the modulating signals are modulated with carriers having different frequencies. The bandwidth ranges for each of this carrier and associated modulating signal are referred as the channels. Between these particular channels, there is usually a small gap, and this small strips, you can say, or this particular small strips, they are called the guard bands to prevent the signal from overlapping. We shall see in detail about this. So this is the process of the frequency division multiplexing. So we have this modulating signals, three different modulating signals. For modulating signal 1, carrier frequency 1 is used and we get a modulated signal. For the second modulating signal, another carrier having the frequency F2 is used, and we get the another frequency modulated wave, or we get a modulating signal. That may be frequency modulated or it may be amplitude modulated, it can be anything, but the carrier is having the frequency F2, while for the third modulating signal, the carrier will be having the frequency F3. So we have this three modulated signals, one with carrier frequency F1, second with the carrier frequency F2, and the third with the carrier frequency F3. all these modulating signals, they are combined, and this process of combining these three different modulating signals, so these particular three different modulating signals, they are having different frequencies. So even if we are combining this signal at the transmitter, these three signals, they can be easily separated at the receiver. Okay. So this process of combining the frequency modulated signal is the frequency division multiplexing. So what you get at the output of this is a single signal, which is the frequency division modulated signal, we can say. So what happens at the receiver as the signal comes from the channel at the receiver, then this signal is given to the different filters. So the first filter is having a band which allows the carrier frequency F1 and the frequencies around F1. So the first filter will allow only the first frequency modulated signal through it. The second filter will allow the second frequency modulated signal whose carrier is F2. It will not allow any signal from F1 or F2, that is the frequencies which are near F1 and F2 will not be allowed by this particular F1 and F3 will not be allowed by this particular filter F2. Okay, so each filter has its own band in, and it filters, it separates the other modulating signals. So after these are separated, then as we discussed in second unit, a demodulator is used at the receiver, and that demodulator removes the carrier from the modulating signal, and the output of the demodulator is the audio signal. So there are three demodulators here, because in the FDM there were three modulating signals combined, and each of the demodulator gives the analog output. So we can see here that three signals were required to be sent at the sender, and three signals are received at the receiver. Let us work on this particular example on the frequency division multiplexing. Assume that a voice channel occupies a bandwidth of 4 kilohertz. We need to combine three voice channels into a link with a bandwidth of 12 kilohertz, from 20 kilohertz to 32 kilohertz. Show the configuration using frequency domain. Assume there are no guard bands. So this can be easily done by shifting the voice signal by having the carrier of appropriate frequency. For example, each of these three voice channels belongs to, or they need some bandwidth, or particularly they need 4 kilohertz of bandwidth. So they will use different frequency bands. The total frequency band given is 20 kHz to 32 kHz. So effectively the bandwidth is 12 kHz, and each channel has 4 kHz. Each channel needs 4 kHz bandwidth. So the first channel can use the bandwidth from 20 kHz to 24 kHz. The second channel can use 24 kHz to 28 kHz, and the third channel can use from 28 kHz to 32 kHz of the total bandwidth. So when this particular signals are using the bandwidths like this, for example, the first modulator, this is the 4 kHz signal. Each of these are the 4 kHz input signals, and we use a modulator and we choose the carrier frequency such that the modulating signal will have the bandwidth from 20 to 24 kHz. Again, here the modulator, we use a modulator such that the modulating signal generated by this particular modulator will be within the band 24 kHz to 28 kHz, whereas the third modulator, the carrier frequency will be such that its output will be 28 kilohertz to 32 kilohertz. So typically we have seen in the second unit that there are different modulating techniques in the amplitude modulation even, and one of the technique is the single sideband technique. So here typically you can use single sideband technique for this particular purpose. So the carrier frequency for the first modulator will be 20 kHz, and we are going to select the upper sideband. For the second modulator, the carrier frequency can be 24 kHz, and we are selecting only one sideband, that is the upper sideband. And for the third modulator, the carrier frequency can be 28 kHz, and we are selecting only the upper sideband of that particular modulating signal. And we can combine this so that this signal can be sent over this particular channel, and it will be having the frequencies from 20 kHz to 32 kHz. Okay, so this band is given for the transmission, and at the receiver there will be band pass filters. The first band pass filter will filter the frequencies between 20 to 24 kHz, giving only the first modulating signal, and the demodulator here will demodulate it and give the original 4 kHz signal. So each of these signals, modulated signals, will be demodulated to produce the original signal. So this is how that can be solved. This is another example. Here 5 channels are required, each with 100 kilohertz bandwidth are to be multiplexed together. What is the minimum bandwidth of the link if there is a need for a guard band of 10 kilohertz between the channels to prevent the interference? So in this example, we are proposing, or it is required, to use the guard band between the channels. So For the 5 channels, we need at least 4 guard bands. This means that the required bandwidth is at least, that is, the bandwidth required by each channel is 100 kilohertz. So 100 into 5, and to separate these guard bands, there will be 4 guard bands in between this, and each guard band is of 10 kilohertz. So the total bandwidth required would be 540 kilohertz. Okay, so this can be shown graphically in this fashion. So these are the 5 channels with 100 kilohertz bandwidth, and these are the 4 guard bands, and each guard band is having the bandwidth of 10 kilohertz. Okay, the purpose of this guard band is to ensure that there is no overlapping between the signals of one channel with the other channel. So in this lecture we have studied frequency division multiplexing, and we have also solved some numericals based on this frequency division multiplexing. In the next lecture we shall see wavelength division multiplexing and the two types of time division multiplexing. This is the first question from the assignment 5. So you take your time to solve this question. You can ask your questions on this lecture, and you can share your responses on the lecture or on the assignment to my email ID barbendanandit@sanjivani.org.in, or even you can use our WhatsApp group, yes, that is SEIT 2022 batch, or we have even created a separate group, WhatsApp group for this FCCN. You can use that group even, but in the beginning you can use this group so that everybody will be encouraged to ask questions and share responses, and later on I expect that the conversation for this subject will happen on the WhatsApp group, which is particularly created for the subject FCCN. Earlier we were using that group for COA. The presentation of this particular video and the other literature for that for this particular unit and lecture I shall be sharing with you on github.com, and you can visit this particular URL to get that particular literature as well as the lecture presentation. So thank you for your attention, and we shall meet in the second lecture. I hope these lectures will prove fruitful for preparations of your examinations, because before your examinations you may be having little preparation leaves, and it will not be possible to conduct, it may not be possible to conduct the lectures in the classrooms even if the examinations are postponed. Okay, but there is no notification as to when the examination, whether the examinations are really going to be postponed or not. The examinations are scheduled in the month of May, and you be prepared for this particular examination. So thank you, and we shall meet in the next lecture. Thank you.